What's up guys, Dr. Brute7 signing in. So this is not going to be a tutorial video, rather I'll be talking about the most common error codes that we all face while using Atmosphere custom firmware. Now keep in mind, every error codes are different and there's plenty of them which I don't even know. Like one of the most recent ones that I've faced. If you check my comment section, I try my very best to help you guys out with the possible resolutions. However, I sometimes fail to do so because nobody in this world is perfect. That's the point of making this whole video. I'm trying to jot up all the common error codes and try to talk about them. This is not by any means a 100% guaranteed solution video, rather this is a know your way video. I'll talk about the most common error code, which is the O1000, and a lot of you guys will face it, and it's related to custom themes. Happens every time when you upgrade or downgrade your custom firmware with custom themes installed. However, I've already said this in one of my videos before. It's not entirely the fault of custom themes, rather just a part of it. You can apply the themes for each screen individually, and this code is mostly related to the theme for the lock screen. If you don't apply the theme for the lock screen, then even after the updates, you won't receive this error code. But if you do, then just go to the Atmosphere folder, then go to contents and look for the folder with the O1000 code and delete it. Second one is related to tinfoil. The app might not work properly due to a number of reasons, and a lot of times it's because you have updated your Atmosphere custom firmware. In that case, just try to reapply the SIG patches, the most updated SIG patches. If it doesn't work, then you're going to have to do a full reinstall. Which install files to use, please check out my tinfoil installation video. The third one is basically any other types of random codes. Now take it with a grain of salt guys, this might or might not work for you. But it's best to take this approach before starting all from scratch. I have recently encountered an unknown error code, like I've said at the beginning, and there might be some fatal error codes or anything that has an issue with the bootloader or anything. All you have to do is use the latest version of the custom firmware files and SIG patches. It might resolve the issue, or it might not. But this is the default approach that, according to my experience, it's best to use the files through my videos though, because they are repacked by some very experienced people. Just copy and override the custom firmware files and you'll be good to go. You don't have to look for anything individually. Instead, just download the repack files, extract them and copy and paste them, override them. In most of the cases, it resolves the issue, but in some cases it doesn't. For those times, you can delete the Atmosphere folder and paste a fresh one. And if it still doesn't work, you might have to start from scratch. There are error codes related to Super Smash Bros. Now this is a complicated game and it crashes the system for a lot of you guys, especially those using mods. Make sure you don't have custom themes installed or don't have a lot of sys modules added to your Tesla menu. More overlays you add, the more system memory gets used, and that creates more frequent crashes. That's not just for the game itself, rather for the custom firmware as a whole. Just disable them through your Tesla menu and you should be good to go. And crashes while trying to run RetroArch happens when you're not putting the system on full RAM mode. Always access full RAM mode before running RetroArch. So yeah, these are the most common issues that you guys might face and their most probable solutions provided. Hope you found this video useful. If you did, please make sure to like and subscribe my channel. Leave a comment. I'm very much active on my channel. I'll try my best to help you out. And yeah, until next time, next video, Dr. Brute7 signing off. Peace.